Hello everyone, welcome to TQP 8 classes, an initiative by the TQP faculties. I am Neel Bhatnagar. I have completed my M.Tech from IIT Gwalior in Digital Communication in 2014. I have qualified GATE exam 6 times. At present, I am working as an assistant professor at SETI Vidisha, Madhya Pradesh. I have more than 4 year teaching experience. So this is the 20th lecture of the lecture series of Random Variable and Random Process.
Okay, this question was asked in GATE EC 2014. Real band limited random process XT has two sided power spectral density. It means it is the PSD of the random process XT has been given to you in this form. And the F is the frequency expressed in hertz. The signal XT modulates a carrier cos 16,000 pi t. The resultant signal is passed through an ideal band pass filter of unity gain with center frequency 8 kHz and bandwidth 2 kHz. The output power in watts is. So, what is the language of question? I am drawing the block diagram. There is a multiplier. Here is our input render process, that is XT. Then this render process is modulated by the carrier 16,000 pi t. That is 16,000 pi t. Okay. After that, we will get new random process that is equal to yt. Now, we have given the power spectral density of this XT random process. Now, this random process passed through a bandpass filter. It is a bandpass filter. And the nature of bandpass filter is like that. Its magnitude is unity. Okay. The center frequency is 8k. It is minus 8k. Its gap is 2k. 2k and it's also 2k. So that's why it's become 9k and it's become 7k. It's become minus 7k, it's become minus 9k. Okay, after passing through this bandpass filter, we will get a new random process, that is ZT. Now we have to find the power of the random process ZT. As a hint, you have to given the power spectral density of the input random process. So we have to deal this question in terms of power spectral density. First our task is to find the random process of this power spectral density of this random process. After that, we have to use the property of that is equal to minus infinite to plus infinite, that is equal to power of ZT, that is equal to minus infinite to plus infinite as ZZF DF. We have to use this property. After that, we will get our result. Now for this we have to use the modulation property. So we have to use the modulation property, the 7th property. If two random processes XT and YT are having following relationship like this, as this relationship we have seen in our question. If in our question this term is cos 16,000 pi t. Okay. 16,000 pi t, it can be written as cos bracket 2 pi into 8 into 10 to power 3 t. Okay, or in this you can see f naught equal to 8 kilohertz. After comparing this, f naught is 8 kilohertz. Now if XT, this render process has the power spectral density that is equal to x of f. So after the multiplying by cos 2 pi f naught t, the power spectral density of the render process y t, it is equal to 1 by 4 times of first there is a delay in the frequency domain. There is a delay in the frequency of power spectral density of active by f naught, and then introduce it advance by the frequency f naught
by the frequency f naught in the power spectral density of the random process xt. Okay, we have used this, we have to use this. So follow the instruction of question step by step. So first it is the signal is modulus by carrier this. So here is our xt and this power spectral density is x of f. Okay, now it is multiplied by cos, and I am writing it as 2 pi into 8 into 10 to power 3 t, or you can say here f naught equal to 8 kilohertz. F naught equal to 8 kilohertz. After that we will get yt, new random process, that is yt. So power spectral density of the random process yt is equal to fy of f, that is equal to 1 by 4 times of bracket s x of f minus f naught plus s x of f plus f naught. That is okay. Now we are going to draw the this term, this PSD, that is equal to s x of f. After that we will plot the s by f. Okay, now see here, at put a t f equal to 0, here f equal to 0 and its frequency is f, so it's become 3000 into 10 to the power minus 6, it's become 3 into 10 to the power minus 3. Okay, then put f equal to 1, here minus 1, it is plus 1. So you can see it's frame a triangle shape. So s x of f like this, here is frequency f. So the zero is otherwise means for minus 3 to 3 kilohertz, minus 3 kilohertz plus 3 kilohertz. Okay, and it is zero. Its value at put f equal to 3 or minus 3, you will get 0. 3 kilohertz or minus 3 kilohertz, you will get 0. And f equal to 0, it's become three into ten to the power minus three. Then at f equal to minus 1k, and similarly for f plus 1k, you will get the value, that is for put f equal to 1, so you will get 2 into 10 to the power minus 3. So okay, this is the PSD of random process. This is the plot of the PSD of random process xt. Now we have to plot the power spectral density of the random process yt. This is fy of f, that is equal to 1 by 4 times of bracket s x of f minus f naught and plus s x of f plus f naught. Okay, here f naught is equal to 8k. Here f naught is equal to 8k. Okay, this is f. Okay, now you can see here, first we have to make a delay of 8 kilohertz. It means we have to add 8 kilohertz in our frequencies. It means first we have to add here 8k, here plus 8k, here plus 8k, add here 8k, add here and 8k add here. So it's become, so the center frequency is 0, so it's at here 8k, it's shifted it here. And the make the I'm plot, first I'm drawing this term, and the amplitude is reduced by 1 by 4 factor. So it's also in the shape of triangle, and its magnitude is like this. It's become 3 by 4 into 10 to the power minus 4, not minus 4, this minus 3. Okay. It's a peak amplitude. Okay. 8 plus 3 is equal to 11k. And 8 minus 3 is equal to 5k. इट्स 5 के, ओके ओके 8 प्लस 1 आई यूज 1 बिकॉज़ दिस 1 विल हेल्प इन आवर, ये 1 आपकी हेल्प करेगा क्वेश्चन में, तो 8 प्लस 1 इज इक्वल टू 9 के, हियर इज 9 के एंड 8 माइनस 1 इज इक्वल टू 7 के, इज 7 के, ओके सो मैग्नीट्यूड एट दिस पॉइंट इज इक्वल टू, इट इज इक्वल टू 2 के, मैग्नीट्यूड एट दिस पॉइंट इज इक्वल टू एंड 2 इन बाय 4 इंटू 10 टू माइनस 3 एंड सिमिलर थिंग विल यू प्लॉट इन द नेगेटिव साइड ऑफ द फ्रीक्वेंसी, ओके Now we now for by help of this we have to add minus 8k here, minus 8k minus 8k, okay, minus 8k here and minus 8k here, we have to add, so we will get the same shape, we will get the same shape, okay, this will look like this, almost look like this. This magnitude is also and the 3 by 4 into 2 minus 3, it is at because we had 0 plus minus 8, it's become so the jo value plus 8k ban rahi hai wo banegi minus 8k pe, as it is replica ban rahi hai iski y axis ke along, ye ban raha hai aapka minus 7k and this become minus 5k, so it become minus 9k and it become minus 11k, okay, the magnitude is there, okay, now we have reached up to this point, we have reached at this point, now the resultant signal is passed through a ideal band pass filter of unity gain, so it is your band pass filter, that band pass filter its magnitude is equal to 1 because it's a unity gain, it is a band pass filter, it says that its center frequency is 8k, here is 8k and it is minus 8k and the gap is 2 kilohertz, that is 2k, it is 2k, it is 2k, so that's why the gap is 2k, so 1 above 1 below, so it's become 1 below is 7k and it's become 7 kilohertz and it's become 9 kilohertz, okay, it's become minus 7 kilohertz, it's become minus 9 kilohertz and this signal x, this the PSD of the random process YT and this band pass, we will multiply both signal frequency domain, we will use the multiplication property, so that's why when we will multiply both the signal, the power spectral density of this random process YT and the band pass filter. You can see after the common area is in between this region. The common area is in between this region. Okay, and this region is not common in the. This region is not common in both the signals. That's why this is the common area. So ये portion ही रह जाएगा. Other than this portion and this portion will be vanish after passing through the this band pass filter. So now again I am plotting the now I am and after that we will get the power spectrum density of jet random process jet t. Now this is the random process PSD of the random process jet t and that is look like this triangle and this vertical shape and this also look like and the magnitude in this region is same. I am just writing this here. Same. This mag. Okay. It is minus 8k. It is प्लस 8k, it is just above 9k and just below 7k, it is just minus 7k, minus 9k. Okay, the magnitude is 2 by 4 into 10 to minus 3, and here the magnitude is 3 by 4 into 10 to minus 3. Okay, this is the PSD of the outputs random process. It means let's say the output random process ZT. So this is the PDF of the output random process or ZT random process. Okay, now we have to find the power. So we have to find the power. It means we have to find the value that is Z0, our autovision function at tau equal to 0. Then, or it can be written as expectation of Z square T, or it can be written as integration minus infinite to plus infinite as Z of f df. So we have to find the area of, we have to find the integration from minus infinite to plus infinite of this PSD. Or in other words, you have to find the area of this shape. You have to find the area of this shape. Okay. Z t. That is equal to. Now both are symmetrical. That's why I am writing the two times here, and I am calculating the area of this single portion that is equal to. So it's become a rectangle. It's become a rectangle shape. So and so the its area is equal to length into width. So width is 9 minus 7k, that is equal to 2 kilohertz. 2 into 10 to the power 3 into its height is, this height is 2 by 4. 2 by 4 into 10 to the power minus 3. Then plus. Then area of this triangle. Area of this triangle, that is equal to half into base is 9 minus 7k, that is equal to 2 into 10 to the power 3 into the this height. This height is equal to 3 by 4 minus 2 by 4 into 10 to the minus 3, that is equal to 1 by 4 into 10 to the power minus 3. Okay. This minus 3 to this minus 3 cancel. This minus 3 to this minus 3 cancel. This 2 and this 4 cancel. So this become 1 plus 2 to 2 cancel. That's it's become only 1 by 4. And 2 is there. So it's become 2 into 5 by 4. Or you can say 5 by 2 watt. Or in other words, it's become 2.5 watt. So correct answer of this question is 2.5 watt. Okay, this question was asked in GATE EC 2003. The random process XT with constant mean and value mean value 0 and auto coefficient function, that is Rx tau, that is equal to this. Okay, X be the Gaussian random variable obtained by sampling process TI. So X jo aapka random variable hai. XT is a random process, and XT random process hai. Ye process hai. Ye aapka random variable. Okay, the Q function definition de rakhi hai. Find the probability that X less than equal to 1. Find the probability that X less than equal to 1. Okay, first part solve karte hai. As we know that the mean of, it is given that mean of this random process is equal to 0. So the also the mean of this random variable X obtained at the this time instant of this random process, its mean is also equal to 0. Okay, that is equal to mean. Okay, now we have to find the sigma X square. It means variance of this random variable X, that is equal to expectation of X square minus expectation of X whole square. This term is already 0. Okay, now it is equal to expectation of X square, and it is equal to R XX 0. So put the value Rx is 0 here. it's become 4 times of e to the power minus 0.2 mod 0 plus 1. E to the power 0 is equal to 1. This term become 1. 1 plus 1 2, 2 into 4 is equal to 8. So sigma, I am writing is sigma square only. It's a sigma square. Sigma square is equal to 8. So sigma equal to 2 root 2. Sigma equal to root 8, that is equal to 2 root 2. Okay. Now we have to find the probability that x, probability of p, x less than equal to 1. So in, and the x is a Gaussian under variable. X is Gaussian. When we were studying the Gaussian under variable, so you can remember that is the definition of CDF. It is the definition of CDF. Because the CDF of f of x, that is equal to probability that x is less than equal to x. It, this definition is common for all type of random variable. But it's equal to 1 minus q function of bracket x minus mu upon sigma. This term is only valid for the Gaussian random variable. Gaussian random variable. We have discussed this thing in the starting of the Gaussian random variable. Okay. Now you can see here, here is 1. Here is 1. Px less than equal to 1. It means it is equal to 1. It is equal to 1. And it is equal to 1. Here mu is 0. Here sigma is equal to 2 root 2. Sigma is equal to 2 root 2. So apply all this thing in this expression. So it's equal to 1 minus q function of, that is equal to x is equal to 1 minus mu is equal to 0 and sigma is equal to 2 root 2. So it's become 1 minus q function of 1 upon 2 root 2. So correct answer of this question is option D. So option D is correct. Now it's part B. Let y and z be the random variable obtained by sampling at t equal to 2 and t equal to 4. So y equal to, it is random variable obtained from the random process xt at time instant t equal to 2. And z equal to x t 4. And w equal to y minus z. Okay. So w equal to y minus z, that is equal to x2 minus x4. Then find the variance of w. Find the variance of w. So sigma w square. It is called variance of w. So that is equal to expectation of w square minus expectation of w whole square. Okay. It's equal to, put the value w here, it's become here w is equal to x2 minus x4 whole square minus expectation of x2 minus x4 bracket whole square. Okay, then sigma w square, that is equal to, in the expectation, now I am going to open this whole square, that is equal to x square 2 plus x square 4 minus 2, 2 times of, and I am writing x4 first here, x4 and x2. Okay, this expectation minus, now I break the expectation, this term is whole square and this become expectation of x 2 minus expectation of x 4. As we know very well that it is the random variable y and it is random variable z, and the expectation of y and expectation of z, it's the mean of y and mean of z. respectively. So these, as we know that this mean is 0. So all the random value obtained from this random process by different time instant, the all value of mean is equal to 0. This 0 and this will also 0. So this expression, this second term is now removed. Now this become, now again I distribute the expectation, that is become expectation of x square 2 plus expectation of x square 4 minus 2 times of expectation of x4 into x2. Okay, now you can see here this term we have solved so many questions, so this term become rxx of 0. Okay, I hope ye cheez aapko clear hone lagi hogi. This also x mean square value, that is equal to rx is autocorrelation function at tau equal to 0, and this is the autocorrelation function, and this should depend on the time difference, because here there is no term mentioned here. You can mention it is WSS, but the autocorrelation function is depends on the time difference. That's why we have to understood by default, and we have to assume that it is a WSS. So its term become r x x, the difference of 4 minus 2 is equal to 2. Okay, sigma w square, that is equal to r x x of 0 plus r x x of 0 minus 2 times of r x x of 2. Okay, that is equal to 2 times of r x x of 0 minus 2 times of r x x of 4, or equal to, not take 2 common here, that is equal to r x x of 0 minus r x x of 4. Now put the value at first, in first the tau is 0 and here tau is equal to 2, here tau is equal to 2, so put here. So this term become 4 times of e to the power, now 0 minus 0.2 into 0, that is equal to 0, and this plus 1. Okay, now this term become 4 times of bracket e to the power minus 0.2 into 2 plus 1. So after solving this in the virtual calculator, you will get 2.64. So correct answer of this question is option C. So our new topic is band limited white noise. In the last class we have discussed only the white noise. We discussed only white noise. Go through a recall. The white noise. For white noise, its power spectral density is SNN of omega, that is equal to, you can write it term of f also, it is equal to neta by 2 for r frequency of omega. So sari omega ki values ke liye, it means from minus infinite to plus infinite, its power spectral density is equal to neta by 2. Now you have to find the its autocorrelation function, you have to find its autocorrelation function tau. So for this you have to perform the inverse Fourier transform of the this power spectral density of white noise. Okay, for it is power spectral density and this autocorrelation function. Okay, so you have to take the inverse Fourier transform of this power spectral density SNN of omega. Now just recall the some formulas of signal system like that. If del t is a signal, this is called impulse, unit impulse, is FOIL transform, which is equal to 1. And it is 1, which means its constant is for all value omega. Now, if you multiply here by eta by 2, if you multiply it here by eta by 2. So, multiply here eta by 2. So, it's, you have to multiply eta because it's follow the scale. Now, it's become eta by 2 del t, and it is equal to eta by 2 for r value of omega. Okay, so you can see here SSN omega is equal to eta by 2 for r values omega. So here is time, here is the time t, and here it should depends on the time difference. It should depends on the time difference. Okay, now that's why if eta by 2 for r value of omega is its inverse Fourier transform, its inverse Fourier transform, that is equal to eta by 2 del tau. So that's why for this your autocorrelation function of white noise, autocorrelation function of white noise, that is equal to eta by 2 and del tau. Okay, and these are the two properties of the basic of the white noise. And one thing also, the mean value, mean of white noise, and let's say white noise is equal to nt, or white noise nt whose power spectral density is equal to eta by 2 for all value of omega. So mean of this white noise, so it means expectation of nt, and this thing we have discussed in last class, that was 0. So these properties you have to remember all time. Now in case of band limited white noise, a random process nt is called band limited when now its non-zero is non-zero value. It means this is band limited. It means it is limited in the particular band, and after that its magnitude is zero. Okay, in the normal white noise, it contains the infinite bandwidth, but here it contains the finite bandwidth. Okay, its power spectral density, that is equal to eta by 2 for omega, it is equal to omega, that is less than equal to minus omega b to plus omega b, minus omega b to plus omega b, and other than its value is 0. Now you have to find the its autocorrelation function of this band limited noise. You have to find the autocorrelation function of this band limited noise. Now, band limited white noise, its power spectral density, that is SNN omega, it is equal to eta by 2 and it is 0. And it is eta by 2, it's for omega less than equal to minus omega b to plus omega b. Here, omega b is a constant, it is constant. Okay, and it is otherwise. Okay. You have to find the value of R and then tau. It means you have to find the autocorrelation function of this band limited white noise. So we have to take the inverse Fourier transform of this band limited white noise. Okay, we take the inverse Fourier transform of this band limited white noise. The formula of inverse Fourier transform, that is equal to in term of omega, that is equal to 1 upon 2 pi integration minus infinite to plus infinite s nn omega e to the power plus j omega tau d omega. Now you can see here the, now put the values here, now put the proper values, this become 1 upon 2 pi integration, the limits, its non-zero values are exist in between minus wb to plus wb omega b to plus omega, it's a constant, this minus omega v2 plus omega v. Okay, not a problem. And this none with zero values theta by 2 and it's e to the power j omega tau d omega. Now this term is constant, you can take it outside. So it's become theta upon 4 pi after multiplying this. And this integration becomes e to the power j omega tau upon e to the power j omega tau upon and tau is a constant. I put the limit here and j is also there. J is also there. Okay. Minus omega b2 plus omega b. And I am doing a change here. It is 2 and it is 2j. Okay. So equal to now theta upon 2 pi tau. It is there and it is e to the power j omega tau upon 2j. It is there and we put the limit minus wb2 plus wb. So rn and tau. That is equal to 1 of. For meter upon 2 pi tau and e to the power j omega b tau minus e to the power minus j omega b tau and here it is 2j. Now so this entire term become sin omega b tau. Okay, so it becomes meta upon 2 pi tau sin omega b tau. Okay, now make multiply now that multiply it by omega b here and omega b here, so you will get r and n tau. That is equal to theta omega b upon theta omega b upon 2 pi is become sin omega b tau upon omega b tau. Yes. Okay. So you can see here it's become sinc function. It's become a sinc function. It is the autocorrelation function, it is the function of tau and it is r and n tau. So the curve of the plot of this is its function is like this. Okay. Like this. And it's at tau equal to 0. At tau equal to 0, you will get the maximum value of at tau equal to 0, you will get r and n. Tau at tau equal to 0 maximum. One value. Okay. So it's theta upon 2 pi sin omega b. So it's you can see here it's for the band limited power spectrum density in the form of rectangular shape. So its autocorrelation function is like the sinc function. As this and based on this property, based on this relationship, one question has been asked which we have discussed in the last lecture. Okay. So the new topic is transmission of random process through LTI system. If XT be input a random process to a linear time invariant system LTI system with impulse response ST and the output YT output in the processes. So ST is the impulse response when you apply the delta impulse function. So that is the response of this system is called impulse response and it is denoted as ST. So after processing we will get following results. So it's my suggestion not to go in the derivation portion. You have to memorize these three results directly. So first is the new random process will frame after passing through this LTI system. The mean of that random process, that is equal to mod of h of 0. It means st is the impulse response in time domain, and h of omega and either h of f. It is also called impulse response in frequency domain. So capital here it is dependent on capital. It means it is in the frequency domain. So you have to multiply the mean of the random process x with the magnitude at f equal to 0 of the impulse response of the this LTI system. Okay, at f equal to 0 aapko multiply karna hai. Now power spectral density or s of output of this random process yt that is passing through after this LTI system, that is equal to mod of h of omega whole square into x excess of r into x into s excess of r. It means you have to multiply the magnitude square of this impulse response in the frequency domain and with the power spectral density of the random process x, or in other words, it is in the form of omega, it is in the form of f. So things are same in both equations. Now the mean square value of yt, that is equal to expectation of y square t, that is equal to tau equal to 0 of the autogenous function of random process yt, that is equal to 1 upon 2 pi integration minus infinite to plus infinite. And this term is like that, it is equal to 1 upon 2 pi integration minus infinite to plus infinite. Here the PSD of random process y, and here is f and df, or you can say it's omega, because here we use 2 pi, so it become omega. So kindly make sure that which formula you have used. And it is also represent integration minus infinite to plus infinite s y of f df. Now by the help of this put the value here and here, so we will get this value. After that we will get this value. Okay, this is equal to this and this. By the help of these three property, we will going to solve numericals here. A W is the random process XT is applied to an input to the LTI system whose impulse response ST is equal to 3 e to the power minus 2t ut. Find mu y, it means mean of random process yt. When mean of random process xt, it is equal to 2. It is equal to 2. So we have the formula that mu y, it is equal to mod of h of 0 into mu of x. So it's equal to mod of h of 0 at mu of x equal to 2. Now we have to find the first, we have to find h of omega, then take the magnitude and put omega equal to 0 here. So here it is equal to ht equal to 3 e to the power minus 2 t u t. Okay, as we know that e to the power minus 8 t u t is Fourier transform is equal to 1 upon j omega plus a. Now here a is equal to 2, so now make changes. Now I'm going to change here. Now a and a, now change. new question. A random process xt with input to LTI system whose impulse response is st equal to 2 e2 by minus 2 ut. 2 e to the power minus t ut. If autocorrelation function of the random process is this, then power spectral density of output of this system. So the power spectral density output of this system is equal to mod of h of omega whole square into power spectral density of h of omega. Sorry, x of the power spectral density of random process xt. This become omega. First we have to find the value of h. So first we have to find the value h of omega. So h of t, it is equal to impulse response. That is equal to 2 e to the power minus t ut. So its Fourier transform is equal to 2 times of dot. So e to the power minus 80 ut, that is equal to 1 upon j omega plus 1, that is equal to h of omega. Now further, mod h of omega, that is equal to 2 times of root over omega square plus 1. After that, mod h of omega whole square, that is equal to 4 times of omega square plus 1. Okay. Now we have to calculate the value of power spectral density of random process x. Here it is equal to e to the power minus 2 mod tau. This is, so we know very well e to the power minus a mod tau. Its Fourier transform is equal to 2a upon omega square plus a square. That's why it's become 2 into 2, here a is equal to, that's why it's become 2 into 2, which is 4 upon omega square plus 2 square, that is equal to 4 upon omega square plus 4. Okay. Now we have to multiply both terms. Okay. This will become so it becomes 4 upon omega square plus 1, this term, and this term, that is this becomes 4 upon omega square plus 4, that is equal to 16 upon omega square plus 1 into omega square plus 4. So correct answer of this question is option A.